Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Bryant Smith. I'm now out of the light. Let me come back here. There we are. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. It was a good show. Have a good night. We'll see you next year. It's wonderful to see you here this evening. I am Bryant Smith. I'm the director of bands here at Utah Tech University, and we are so grateful that you're here with us this evening. We have a wonderful concert to share with you. Before we start, I just want to very quickly recognize a couple of people who are in our ensemble who are very important. As you can tell, we are doing works for band and choir tonight, and none of this would be possible without our wonderful choir director, Dr. Roger Hale, who is in the back here. Roger, will you stand, please? And I always make sure that I recognize Maestro Gary Caldwell, my predecessor in this job, who continues to be wonderful here. You're wonderful, Gary. Our first selection this evening was, of course, America the Beautiful. It was, of course, the Samuel Augustus Ward, and this arrangement was done by Carmen Dragon. It's an absolute treasure, in my opinion, so I'm glad that we could share that with you this evening. This concert is in conjunction with the fourth annual conducting symposium that we run here on campus. The symposium brings in guest conductors and clinicians, and then also other guests who are teachers from the region, and they come in and we learn for 2 days about the art of conducting, teaching, music, wonderful opportunities to learn together as a group. And as always, we are blessed to bring in wonderful clinicians. This evening, we have the privilege of having two guest conductors with us who will lead these ensembles. We will hear later on, or see later on, Dr. Craig Jessup from Utah State University, who will be with us. We're excited that he is here. He's over here. I'm going to clap for him myself. Our other conductor this evening, we are about to have come onto the stage. He is a wonderful man, hails from Great Britain, and is an absolutely outstanding conductor, but more than that, an outstanding person. He has been a delight to work with the last 2 days. He is also an exceptionally talented composer, and the piece that we're about to hear is an award-winning selection that was written last year, and it is one that he will conduct himself, so we'll have the composer conducting his own piece this evening. It will be called A Midwestern Suite. It has 3 movements. And I will turn the time over now to Dr. Tom Davarin from Benedictine College in Kansas.
Good evening, Utah. That was the most polite woo I think I've ever heard in my entire life, but I've learned that everything about this state is kind and welcoming and polite, and it's just been a wonderful experience being here. I know I can speak for Craig too when I say that working with the high school choir and band directors of the region and working with this wonderful choir and band here at Utah Tech has been a transformative experience. So can we please give a big round of applause to the students of the band and choir? The piece that you're about to hear was composed as kind of a gift to my mentor. I did my doctoral work at the University of Kansas, which is in Lawrence, Kansas, and my teacher, Dr. Popiel, has a legacy like many doctoral teachers do. Some commission music, which kind of feeds out into our canon and our repertoire, and some make recordings that last a lifetime, and Dr. Popiel's legacy is truly his students. He's taught at the University of Kansas for 11 years now, and every single one of his doctoral graduates is in a top-tier college job, and I think that's an amazing legacy that he has. So those of us who are his graduates got together and formed a consortium of several universities, 15 universities and high schools, in fact, across the Midwest region, to compose this piece as a tribute. It's called Midwestern Suite for 2 reasons. Number one, it's based on Midwestern folk song, the state song of Kansas, Home on the Range. You're going to hear it in several different guises. And each of those guys is inspired by a Kansan scene. The first is a rolling prairie. Having landed here a couple of days ago, I can tell that's something that you don't have a lot of here. It's very mountainy. But Kansas has a lot of prairie. And it is an endless, rolling, undulating sight whenever you drive through the state. It's something that can be imposing, but incredibly beautiful too. And the first movement tries to capture that sense of beauty. The second is a storm. Now, I don't know what weather is like for you guys in this state, but when storms come to Kansas, they come to Kansas in a big way. And the second movement tries to capture the sense of drama and ferocity that you'll hear in a typical Kansan thunderstorm. You'll hear Home on the Range voiced as the main material, but in that more aggressive and tumultuous way. And the final movement is a sunrise and sunset. One thing about living in an incredibly flat state is we get these unique skyscapes. I've seen colors in the sky and clouds like I've never seen anywhere in the world in Kansas. It's truly a beautiful sight. And when the sun rises and sets, we see reds, purples, yellows, oranges like I've seen nowhere else. And the third movement is a tribute to that view. So I'm so grateful, as I know Craig is, for the time and artistry of these wonderful students and our participants today. And I hope you all enjoy this performance of A Midwestern Suite for the first time in Utah, I think. Thank you.
Lovely piece of music. I love it. The next piece that we're going to do is going to be a choral piece, and this one will be directed by our director of choral activities, Dr. Roger Hale. Please welcome Dr. Hale to the stage. the Utah Tech Chamber Singers, ladies and gentlemen. So I'm a band guy. It's like one of those things. I love band music, but deep down I have a serious love for choral music. I have sung choral music throughout my life, and I just love listening to it. And there's one composer who absolutely hits me in the heart, and I told Dr. Jessup earlier today that if I listen to too much of his music at the wrong time, I fall into this very relaxed state, and I can't do any work for the rest of the day. So I have to be real careful about Eric Whitaker, specifically his music. But I love his music. And in this particular case, we have the opportunity to perform a band transcription of his wonderful work, Lux Aurumque, which, if I butchered the pronunciation, don't butcher me, okay? But it's a wonderful piece of music, which means light and gold, and the symphonic band will perform that for you now.
Thank you.
you should know that the first clarinets on that song have to basically like play the same note for about a minute straight with no breath. They made it. Give them a round of applause for that. Absolutely. They not only made it, they did a great job. Well done. So one of the main focuses of the conducting symposium has been, again, to have music for band and choir. And the real impetus for it was this next piece of music, which is called, and I'm going to pull this up so I make sure that I don't miss all the movements, but it's called A Little Symphony of English Carols. And I fell in love with this piece, and I hope that you do too. It is a delightful piece. It has 8 movements, each with a different Christmas carol in it. The first one is a miniature overture, on the tune Wassail Song. The second movement is a winter ballad on Sea Amid the Winter Snow. After that is the intermezzo, The Holly and the Ivy. The fourth movement is the first interlude, which is the Coventry Carol. The fifth is the Fireside Frolic, God Rest You Merry Gentlemen. 6 is the second interlude, Away in a Manger. 7th is Reverie in the Bleak Midwinter. And finally, the 8th movement, a festive finale, Ding Dong Merrily on High. We have had the privilege of having, again, another wonderful clinician who has worked with us and has given us great, great instruction over the past few days. And we are just honored that he has been able to be with us. He has been absolutely wonderful, kind, and totally professional, amazing, and an opportunity for these kids to have a chance to be under the baton of one of the world's great composers. Or excuse me, conductors. I almost said composers. We figured that out yesterday, didn't we? So I am very delighted to share this piece, actually, this evening. The first 5 movements are going to be conducted by our guest clinician, Dr. Craig Jessup, after which I will take the last 3 movements. Please welcome to the stage Craig Jessup.
For there is more.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for coming to our concert this evening. We so much appreciate it. Please come back to more Utah Tech events in the future, and we look forward to seeing you next time. Have a lovely holiday season. Thank you.